On July 14th, Victor arrives in the Nicoya Peninsula of Costa Rica. He is dropped off in the small community of San Miguel next to the Pacific Ocean. For the next couple of weeks, he was trained by veteran volunteer coordinators on all aspects of his new position. Learning and adapting quickly, Victor soon takes on an essential role and is moved to the Costa de Oro project site. Located only 5 kilometers to the south, this beach and project is new territory for Potoma within recent years. Starting from the ground up, Victor and his fellow peers set out to build a hatchery and organize the beach for patrolling. Building a hatchery is a lot of work. This starts by marking off the perimeter of the hatchery. Then, the crew starts by digging out the soil. This physically straining task is done with the help of neighboring project site coordinators, volunteers, and locals within the community. The amount of dirt they took out was equivalent to the interior space of 42 VW Beetles, which is 3,600 cubic feet. Now that the hole has been dug, Victor and the volunteers move sand from the beach to the hatchery, making sure to only use sand free of foreign objects. After the hatchery hole had been completely filled, the team found and used fallen trees in the area for posts. They cut the logs to size and scraped off the bark. Digging the post holes, they space and place the wooden post into the ground. As the team does this, they also dig a trench for the netting and tack it in place. This helps prevent animals from crawling underneath the netting. Using bamboo and driftwood to construct the hatchery door, Victor also recycled his personal sandals for hinges. Inside the hatchery, sticks and twine were placed inside the sand to create a grid for the nesting plots. Bamboo was also painted on to indicate the rows and columns. Fishing line was added above the hatchery to prevent predatory birds from entering. With this, the hatchery is now completed and ready for the turtle eggs. From July until the end of November, Victor and the Potoma volunteers patrol the 5 kilometer span of beach looking for nesting female sea turtles. Depending on the tide schedule, they will patrol up to 4 hours a night, walking before and after the high tide. The turtles also utilize this time frame to nest in order to walk a minimal distance on the beach in the cover of the night. After the crew finds a set of turtle tracks, in the dark, they will follow the footprints up the beach in hopes to find a turtle nesting. If they do find a female nesting, they will record her observations, measurements, and depth of nest. If time permits, they will also tag the turtle with a unique identification tag as well. The volunteers will collect all the eggs directly as the mother lays them, or they will attempt to locate the eggs in the ground using sand characteristics and formations left behind by the nesting turtle. The Olive Ridley turtle usually lays 80 to 120 eggs 3 to 4 times during a nesting season. Once these eggs are collected, they are brought to the hatchery to ensure these eggs developed without being in harm's way. Replicating the female turtle's nest bed, the volunteers will dig out a nest in a certain plot and gently place the eggs inside. Roughly 8 weeks later, the developed baby turtle will break out of their eggs and start crawling up to the surface. This process takes place over the span of 2 days. After the majority of the turtles make it to the surface, they are brought to the beach to be released safely into the ocean. Back at the hatchery, there is still work to be done. Victor and the other volunteers will go through each nest to make sure there are no live babies still trying to crawl out. They will also remove all the eggs from the nest and take them to the beach for exhumations. This is the process of identifying and recording what stage each egg stopped developing, as roughly 80% of nested eggs are fertile and become baby turtles.
Warning! Graphic images will be shown.
Going through these eggs, the volunteers will find embryos in the various stages of growth. This includes unfertilized, fertilized, early, middle, and late. Unfortunately, some babies die of suffocation as they do not have enough strength to get to the surface. Others are attacked by insects while still developing inside the egg. Luckily, most of the eggs are empty as the babies have abandoned them. Every so often, the volunteers find unique unfertilized eggs within the nest that can range in different sizes. Unique finds such as twins and albinos are discovered too, however, the majority of them have some sort of fatal deformity. On the brighter side of things, the new Costa de Oro project site was so successful in its first couple months, the Pratoma organization offered Victor and the other coordinators to extend their volunteer service an additional 2 months. With much excitement, they all accepted to continue helping turtles. Victor continued his marketing and fundraising efforts abroad by producing customized patches. These were worn by fans, family, and friends all over the world. He also sent over 70 customized postcards to those who supported him as well. For those that were his largest financial supporters, he provided them with a vicarious visit to Costa Rica. To top things off, Victor Maisano acquired and built the website HelpingTurtles.com, where all of his information and experience was centralized. This included his daily journals, videos, and pictures. Continuing with the conservation program, Victor and the other volunteers do everything they can to protect these turtles. However, not everyone in Costa Rica share the same values. In fact, almost every night, some locals and people from the surrounding areas will walk the beach to collect and poach turtle eggs. These poachers eat and sell them as delicacies. Meanwhile, fish trawling boats just off the coast use sea-floored nets to catch shrimp and fish. At the same time, they also capture sea turtles. When this happens, the turtle gets trapped and drowns as they are unable to get air from the surface.
Warning! Graphic images will be shown.
These dead turtles wash up to the shore several days after this occurrence and completely decompose naturally within 5 days. Day and night for 5 months, Victor, along with the rest of the Pratoma coordinators, work hard to patrol the beach, manage the hatchery, and release the baby turtles into the world. During this time, the project site was able to protect 92 nests with a total of 9,370 eggs. Out of these eggs, 2,579 babies were able to make it to the ocean in hopes for some of them to return 12 years later to nest their eggs on Costa de Oro's beach. In early December, the project comes to a close as the hatcheries empty and the nesting season for the Olive Ridley turtles has ended. Victor packs his things and makes his final travel to the San Jose airport. This concludes Victor Maisano's adventures in Costa Rica with Helping Turtles. Or does it?